Merchant power prices in India have increased by almost a rupee per unit since April last year, mainly because of higher e-auction prices of coal. And if the summer is to be believed, the scorching summer, you would probably believe that the demand for power would anyways go up. Coal shortage at power plants means output also hasn't kept pace with the rising demand. So all of that, and if indeed the economy goes through a bit of an upturn, then even industrial consumption is on the rise. So what would all of this lead to well, spot power prices and overall power prices as well? Prashant Jain, Joint Managing Director and CEO at JSW Energy Johnson, to talk about that and a lot more, really. The company has also announced a 200 megawatt power purchase agreement that they have signed in Punjab yesterday. Prashant, good having you. Thank you so much for joining in. Now, before I come to JSW specific news bits, just a broad view of what's happening with power. You know, earlier merchant power rates used to be very erratic. Even if they would go up, they would come back with equal hurry. I think over the last 9 to 12 odd months, we've arguably seen a sustained uptick in the spot power rates. What's led to this and what could be the near term looking like?
Yeah, good morning, Neeraj. Power prices have strengthened in the current financial year. If I give you contextually, last year average power prices in merchant market for the whole year was 2 rupees 69 paisa, and for the current year it is 3 rupees 20 paisa, and for the current month it is ruling close to 4 rupees at this point of time. And primarily this is happening because of the two things. One is that there is no additional capacity which is coming up in the market. So rather, in the current financial year, there is a decline in the capacity in the thermal space. Second thing is the power demand is increasing quarter on quarter. Last year, the power demand grew by 2.5%. And current year, the growth is close to 6% for the entire year. The current quarter, for the January and February, the growth is in excess of 7.5% to 8%. And last quarter, it was 6.6%. So it's continuously increasing. So two sides which are happening. One side, demand is increasing. Another side, supply is contracting. On top of it, the third thing is the availability of coal. So coal production has not increased. Some dispatches have increased because of the some stock which was available with Coal India, but precisely the PLFs are not able to sustain it should sustain to meet the demand. So that's why you are seeing little bit hardening of the spot prices.
But do you think this is a phenomenon that could last? Because I mean, in a manner of speaking, Prashant, and please correct me if I'm wrong, in a manner of speaking, this would have been the longest up cycle, if I can call it that, in spot power prices that we've seen in a really long time. Because previously, I remember they used to be very, very erratic and would come off very, very quickly as well.
In last 4 or 5 years, you have been seeing a lot of capacity which was getting added up, and whereas the demand was not growing. And it all started from 2008, when everybody wanted to set up the power capacity, and those capacities were coming up between 2012 to 2017. And now, as we know that there is already a overcapacity and no new capacity is coming up, whereas the demand has been continuously going up. Right now, if you see, there is a countrywide, the PLF, which had hit 56% for the thermal power sector. Now it is ruling at 61%. So continuously the demand is going up, and then so is the PLF, and no new capacity will be coming up. So because of which you will see the strengthening of the power prices in time to come. So we are in the same scenario where we were in 2004 to 2008.
Some reports also indicate that rising coal prices could be a big factor as well. International markets believe coal prices have risen. The Chinese demand for coal, alongside with limited coal output growth, would also be a factor out here. Would you agree with the same?
Not really, because in India, the power prices are not determined based on the imported coal-based power. It is primarily based on the domestic coal. And if I give you the context, the NTPC weighted average power cost is 3 rupees 30 paisa, And most of the power, you know, out of 220 gigawatt of thermal power, close to 190 is the coal based, and out of that only 20 gigawatt is the power which is based on the imported coal. Rest all power is based on the domestic coal. So it's all decided by the domestic coal, not by the imported coal.
Okay, so what would all of this mean for JSW? And we'll also talk about the power purchase agreements and the recent one that you signed as well. But I believe you sell about 30% of your total capacity in the merchant market. All of this should augur well for you, right?
Yeah, for the current year, yes. Now the prices are strengthening, because of which our PLFs will be rising. And for the current year, we had started our long-term portfolio for power was 64%, which we have now increased to 74%. So now, as we are speaking, our 26% is the power which is not tied up and which we are selling in the merchant market. And higher prices, which helps us to run the plant full. But it doesn't give us a big impact on our bottom line also, because at this point of time, the coal prices are also ruling high.
Okay. And would you want to shed some light on this PPA that you've signed? I believe it's in line with what you've been doing, because I think you just told me that 76% or 74% of the total capacity is now being tied up with.
Yeah, so we have signed this 200 megawatt PPA with Punjab, and before that we had signed 176 megawatt with Haryana. So now with this PPA, our entire hydro capacity is fully tied up. This is for 25 years CERC determined tariff, and our Rajasthan project is also 100% tied up. Now we have two imported coal-based power plant. One is in Karnataka, another is in Maharashtra. Now those plants part are tied up on a long term, and balance are based on the merchant tariff. Going forward, we are working with the domestic coal tie-up, and we have already secured necessary environmental approvals. And now, in going forward, in the Shakti linkage scheme, we will be bidding for that, and then we would like to bid for the PPAs and then tie up that capacity also.
So what does all of this do, Prashant, to how quarter four shapes up and how arguably FY19 shapes up compared to what people were estimating? Q3 was a miss. Maybe compared to what you were wanting as well, quarter three would have been a miss. Will quarter four be slightly better than that? And what about FY19? Because everybody is talking about how, while merchant power rates may be volatile, coal prices are not looking like volatile and staying higher. There is a Macquarie note that I'm reading which is talking about the trend of continuous increase in coal prices as well. What are your thoughts here?
So in JSW Energy, quarter three, quarter four are seasonal quarter, because you know we have a mix of both the thermal as well as hydro capacity. Out of 4.6 gigawatt of our total capacity, 1.3 gigawatt is hydro, which we have the seasons of quarter one and quarter two are the entire, most of the 85% income come in that particular quarter. So that's why you cannot see on quarter on quarter basis profits in JSW Energy or the operating performance. On a year on year basis, what I can talk about is that going forward, next year the capacity utilization and PLFs will be better than the FY18. And we have undertaken a couple of things in the current financial year, which we will be reaping the fruits going forward. One is that we have increased our long-term PPA portfolio by close to 10% so that will give a clear visibility and then a stable cash flow in next financial year. Second thing we have undertaken, we repaid close to 2,500 crore of debt during the current financial year till December. And also we refinanced our entire debt our interest costs went down by close to 1.1%. So these two things will be giving us lower interest costs, and because of which our PBT will be positively impacted.
So you would, I mean, and in EBITDA, I mean, you know, the assumptions that people are baking in is that while your revenue growth numbers will look reasonably good in FY19 going into FY20 as well, EBITDA could remain stagnant. Is that a correct estimate or would you beg to differ?
So EBITDA is a function of higher PLF. If we do higher PLF, then EBITDA will be positively impacted. And if our interest cost comes down, then our PBT will be impacted positively.
Okay. One last question. The electric vehicle foray, I mean, is this some time away or could it happen sooner rather than later?
So our target is 3 to 4 years we will be launching the first vehicle, and at this point of time we are working on building the capabilities, and very soon we will be announcing something about the leadership team which will be appointed in EV vehicle space. And also we are working on the product strategy for which you will be hearing very soon. Between in probably 6 to 9 months, some concrete plans will be announced.
Well, the country desperately needs it, Prashant. I go out scanning for availabilities and there aren't too many options but for the Mahindras. But thank you so much for taking the time out, Prashant Jain, and speaking to us. Really appreciate your time today.